please welcome Russell Peters!
Hello. Hi, Yorgo.
Hi, Russell.
How are you, man?
How are you, buddy?
It's going all right, Iz.
Oh, yeah! Nice to see you. So, welcome to the program.
This is good this way.
This is nice, right? How's your baby?
She's great.
Yeah?
She asked about you.
Is she funny? She's well, two, I believe, right?
She'll be three in December.
Amazing.
She pooed, so I thought she was talking about you. But she's great.
Has it changed you significantly?
I wouldn't say significantly, but I genuinely care about somebody now. Like, you know, the same way you care about your mother and your brother and your father.
Yeah.
But even more.
How is that? What's that like?
You don't know yet, right? Because you don't eat meat, but... vegans will never have children.
Why will we never have children?
There's not enough protein in your sack.
It's really good.
You know when you hear people say, I would throw myself in front of a bus for my child?
Yeah.
If you don't have a kid, you're like, no. I would throw myself in front of a bus
That's
for my
so
kid.
Interesting. That's so amazing.
What's it's not like you go, I can't wait for a bus, you know, one day. Look, I hope I don't have to throw myself in front of a bus, but I will if I have to.
You need to. What do you, so when you go on these big, like this Notorious, you know, you have these gigantic concert films, this whole experience that you're used to, are you different on stage now? Are you more aware of the fact?
No, I'm still me. I haven't let fatherhood make me, you know, water me down.
Right.
I am me, and I, you know, there was a period, as you know, you've known me for a long time, but there was a period for a little bit where I was a little cloudy on stage, and my thoughts were there was walls, I was being boxed in as far as my mentally, I felt.
Why was it?
Marriage, and then, you know, you start worrying about somebody else's feelings, and, oh, are they gonna be upset? And then when you get free again, I mean, single, I'm back to me again.
I think people take things too seriously. We've become a precious culture.
We have. Look, if you look at TV in the 70s versus TV now, and you see the things people said back in the day, they said the most off-color stuff, and nobody's feelings were hurt. Do you know why? Because it's about intent. The intent then was to make you laugh, and the intent is still to make you laugh, but they've drilled it into your head that you're not supposed to laugh at this.
Right.
You want to hear the truth? Talk to an old person. How many old people here? Like real old, not you, sir.
What do you mean, like, what? Like,
I mean, you're an older gentleman, but you're not old enough for you to just be like, blah! You know what I mean? I could tell, like, he dresses well, so he's like, I wouldn't say that, you know? But, like, there's an older lady right there. She probably still calls black people colored and Chinese people oriental. But they don't mean anything. It's just, that's what we grew up with, you know? My dad used to call my friends Negroes.
Yeah. He did?
Yeah. Russell, the Negroes are at the door. You know? And I'm like, Dad, you can't say that. Why? What are they? The bloody Negroes. You know?
Speaking of your father, take a look at this.
Okay.
Well, I wanted him to be a white-collar worker, an accountant or something like that, you know? The usual traditional stuff that people from India go on. But after living here for a few years, and about the time Russell was just about ready to leave school, I discovered that you can't stand in their way. You must let them do what they want to do. And I said, okay, want to be a chef? Then go chef's training. But unfortunately, or fortunately for him, in his last year in school, he did a complete about face. So no, I don't want to be a chef. He wanted to go into show business.
Mm-hmm. That's what happened. I imagine you think about your pops. What do you think when you see him talking about you in that respect?
It's funny for me because my dad had this way of just leaving these little pauses when he would talk to add drama to something. Like, suddenly, George had a new TV show. It was on CNN.
Thank you.
This is...
Friday nights on Much Music. Much Music, if you don't know, was a TV channel that used to play music. They stopped doing that a long time ago, but they used to also have dance shows, and, you know, Electric Circus was one.
Matter of fact, it was only on City TV back then.
Then
Much Music syndicated across the country.
You worked on that show.
I did. I used to be a... See what she's doing, following him with the camera and holding the cable?
Yep.
That's what I did.
You pulled the cable.
I was a cable puller.
Right. Let me run a quick anthropology by you. Ready? DJ Jazzy Jeff or The Fresh Prince?
Jazzy Jeff.
Gandhi or Dalai Lama?
Gandhi.
Carlin or Cosby?
Carlin.
If heaven exists, how do you imagine it?
Tucker's Marketplace.
That's
just a great buffet all day.
What's an Indian stereotype we don't know about?
Indian stereotype you don't know about is that if you open up an Indian person's fridge, anything that's in a plastic container like marked margarine or yogurt, it's not margarine and it's not yogurt. It's some sort of leftover food.
If you had to do a 2-hour set, would you rather be comedy or DJing?
Probably DJing.
Do you still, like, I mean, I know when
I've been... I love DJing.
I've been to your house, no matter what time it is, you'll cut records. You don't mind that at all?
I don't mind that at all.
Can you tell, oh, that's starting from scratch, that's Scratch Bastard, that's...
I can tell people's cuts, yeah.
Okay, let me show you. Whose is this?
That's Scratch.
Now take a look at this. Who's this over here over your shoulder?
That's Mastermind.
Mastermind right there. Boy, you can say hi to Mastermind right over there. I want to see how good you can do.
Ah, shoot. Nice.
With Mastermind on the record. I was thinking of that.
I'm just trying to figure out how you got clearance.
I know, right? Well, listen, we don't even know how. We don't even ask. You're so good when you do it. Would you do it?
Yeah.
Would you show some stuff?
I'll do it.
All right. How are you, Mastermind?
I'm good.
What was he like in the early days?
Funny, always funny.
Yeah?
Always funny, great DJ. Actually, his DJ skills have surpassed mine by leaps and bounds. He should actually be doing this.
But I'm not doing this for anyone else but me.
Hi, P-Double. All right, what are we doing here?
Pick whatever you want.
So what are you thinking of when you're starting to construct this? What's it going through your mind?
I'm just gonna, throw it down and I just kind of feel the record out and see. Can I get volume so I can...
Do we get louder here?
Yeah.
Here we go. It's stuff like that, that's
what I like. Thanks, George. Thank you, as always. Russell Peters, everybody. Mastermind.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Good to see you again.